In this module, we will understand the different pests and diseases that can impact the banana plantation, and we'll also understand the different fertilizers or chemicals that should be used by farmers to manage these pests and diseases attack on their plantations. Let us begin by understanding pseudostem borer. Pseudostem borer is also known as Odiporus longicollis. Pseudostem borer follows a life cycle of forming as an egg, as we can see in the image, converting into larva, from larva into a pupa, and finally growing into an adult. These images show the impact of pseudostem borer on a banana plant. As we can see, the symptoms of pseudostem borer are: adults of pseudostem borer are either reddish brown or black. The grubs bore into the stem and feed within the stem. An initial symptom is in the form of exudation of plant sap and blackened mass that comes out of the hole bored by the grub. Finally, the whole plant dies. The pseudostem borer pest is active during monsoon and summer months. The next thing is how to manage pseudostem borer. In extreme scenarios, in case of severe infection, the affected plant should be uprooted and burnt. The other options to manage pseudostem borer are: the first one is use of Selfos. 3 tablets per plant is recommended for control of egg, larva, pupa, and adult population of the insect. After placing the tablet inside the pseudostem, the slit should be plastered with mud. Clean cultivation is an important measure for its control. The second option is to apply Carbosan or Mangala Bold, which is Carbofuran 3G at the rate of 10 grams per sucker. It is very effective to control the pest. Option 3 is to spray Mangala Mahakil or Monosan, which is Monocrotophos 36, at the rate of 50 milliliters of Monocrotophos 36% SL with 500 milliliters of water, and inject 4 milliliters, which is 2 milliliters at 45 centimeters from the ground level, and another 2 mm at 150 cm above the ground level in the pseudostem at monthly intervals from 5th to 8th month. We need to avoid injection of Monocrotophos after the flowering stage. The fourth option is application of Carbaryl WP 0.1%. It also helps in controlling the population of pest. The next one is rhizome weevil. Rhizome weevil is also called Cosmopolitis sordidus. As seen in the images, rhizome weevil emerge into a larva, which grows into a pupa before finally becoming into an adult. The symptoms of rhizome weevil are seen in the images. The larvae or grub of the weevil borer feeds by tunneling in the banana plant. In severe cases, the tunnel extends several feet up the stem. The corm decays and becomes a mass of rotten tissue. Leaves turn yellow and wither and die prematurely. Injury to corm prevents nourishment going to the plant. In heavily infected plantations, production is low. Let us now understand how this pest grows. The adults feed on dead or dying banana plants and live under newly cut or rotting pseudostems. The female weevil either lays eggs in the rotting pseudostem or moves to a living plant where eggs are inserted singly into a hole. The borers spread from plantation to plantation through planting material. How do we control rhizome weevil? Plantations should be clear of debris in which borers can survive. It is most important to clean the planting material from fields known to be free of weevils. Before planting, dipping of suckers in Mangala Mahakil or Monosan, which is monocrotophos 0.5%, for 30 minutes to protect rhizome from weevil attack. Pieces of old rhizomes or pseudostems, which are 1 to 2 feet long, are cut down, split, and placed on the plantation floor between the plants. Adult beetles migrate into these stems and can be collected by hand and poisoned. We can also trap adult weevils with pseudostem chopped into small pieces. Lastly, we can apply Carbosan or Mangala Bolt, which is carbofuran 3G at the rate of 35 grams per sucker, or car barrel 50% WP 20 grams per sucker in the soil around the stem. The next one is banana aphid. Banana aphid is also known as Pentalonia nigronervosa. These visuals show the banana aphid at two different growth stages, nymph and adult. The symptoms of banana aphids are: the insect is the vector of the virus called bunchy top disease. Yellowish green nymphs and adults suck cell sap and devitalize plants. Affected parts become discolored and malformed. The aphids are mostly observed on the lower surface of the leaves. The favorable climate for banana aphids are high humidity. High humidity favors rapid multiplication of this pest. How do we control banana aphid? We need to use virus-free suckers, pairing and pralinage. Pair the corm and sprinkle 40 grams of Carbosan or Mangala Gold, which is carbofuran 3G, over the corm. Before sprinkling, corm should be dipped in mid-slurry. Destroy virus-affected plants by inserting a gelatin capsule containing 200 mg clean 80, which is 2,4-D sodium salt, 80% WP into the corm, 7 cm deep, using capsule applicator. Or inject 5 ml 2,4-D solution, 125 grams per liter of water, into the pseudostem by the injection gun. The plant collapses and topples in 3 to 5 days. Spraying of Mangala Mahakil, which is monocrotophos 0.05%, or Paramida, which is imidacloprid 17.8% SL, at the rate of 1.5 to 2 milliliter per liter at 10 to 15 days interval, contains aphid population effectively. To prevent recurrence of this pest, granular insecticides like Forasan or Fora MCF, which is 4810G, at the rate of 10 kg AI per acre, should be applied to the soil. The next one is burrowing nematode. Burrowing nematode is also known as Rhandopholus similis. The images show the birth of burrowing nematode in the form of multiple eggs and then growing into an adult. The first symptom of this disease is a dark, small dark spot on the root. The nematode deposit eggs in the root tissue. Larvae, after hatching, form the eggs and feed on the root tissue. Fungi rapidly invade such damaged root tissues, and the number of fruits in the bunch are reduced and individual fruits are smaller. Affected plants do not respond to fertilizers, irrigation, or cultural practices, and nematode population is built up rapidly in ratoon crops. How do we manage burrowing nematode? We can pare the corm and sprinkle 40 grams of carbosan or Mangala gold, which is carbofuran 3G, over the corm. Before sprinkling, corm should be dipped in mud slurry. Pare the corms and coat plalinage with Bacillus subtilis, which is BPV, which is BBV 57, and Pseudomonas fluorescens, PF1, each at the rate of 10 grams per corm, followed by soil application at the rate of 1.2 5 kgs each per hectare. In case pre-treatments are not done, then we need to follow different steps, which are: apply carbosan or Mangala gold, which is carbofuran 3G, or forosan or fora MCF, which is folate 10G, at the pit at the rate of 10 grams per pit at the time of planting, or apply neem cake at the rate of 250 to 400 grams per pit at the time of planting. This reduces the pest population. We can grow sun hemp in and around the basin of plants and incorporate their biomass 1 month later, or apply pressed mud at the rate of 15 tons per hectare 1 month after planting, or apply neem cake at the rate of 15 tons per hectare 1 month after planting, or apply Pseudomonas fluorescens, which is PF1, liquid formation at the rate of 4 liter per hectare at second, fourth and sixth month after planting through drip irrigation system to manage Panama wilt and nematode complex. Marigold serves as repellent and traps crops. The next one is Panama wilt. Panama wilt is also known as
Fusarium, Oxyporum, Forma species, Cubens.
This is a soil-borne fungal disease and gets entry in the plant body through roots. It is most serious in poorly drained soils, and this is how visually it looks like in culture and conida form. Initial symptoms of Panama wilt are yellowing of lower leaves, including leaf blades and petioles. The leaves hang around the pseudostem and wither. In the pseudostem of the diseased plant, yellowish to reddish streaks are noted, with the intensification of color towards the rhizomes. Season or climate that helps grow Panama wilt are: wilt is severe in poor soils with continuous cropping of banana, warm soil temperature, poor drainage, light soils, high soil moisture are congenial for the spread of the disease. And as discussed already, it is most serious in poorly drained soils. How do we control Panama wilt? Severely affected plants should be uprooted and burnt. Highly infected soil should not be replanted with banana for at least 3 to 4 years. Use of disease-free planting material and resistant cultivar are recommended. Growing of paddy followed by banana plantation once or twice a year for 3 to 5 years helps. Use of quicklime near the base of the plant and soaking the same with water also helps. Avoid sunflower or sugarcane in crop rotation helps to reduce the disease incidence. Dipping of suckers in trophy or Mangala agraman, which is carbendazim and mancozeb, 10 grams per 10 liter of water, followed by bi-monthly drenching starting from 6 months after planting is also recommended. Application of bioagents such as Trichoderma viridae or Pseudomonas fluorescens in the soil is also effective. The next one is leaf spot, leaf streak or Sigatoka disease. Yellow Sigatoka is also known as Mycus ferella musicola, and black Sigatoka or black leaf streak is also known as Mycus ferella fuginensis. Yellow Sigatoka is one of the serious disease affecting banana crop. Initial symptoms appear in the form of light yellowish spots on the leaves. A small number of these enlarge, become oval, and the color changes to dark brown. Later, the center of the spot dies, turning light gray surrounded by a brown ring. In severe cases, numerous spots coalesce, killing large part of the leaf. As we can see in the images here, we can see the spots on the leaves, and we also see that 5% of the leaf area killed, minimum allowable level of the disease in the NQPA, and when the 15% of the leaf area is killed, that is the maximum allowable outside of the NPQA, which is between November to May, and when 30% of the leaf area is killed, which it is the maximum allowable outside NPQA between June to October. The season or climate in which this disease grows is rainfall, dew, and temperature determine the speed of the disease. Conditions favoring mass infection are most common during the rainy season, with temperatures above 21 degrees Celsius. How to control leaf spot, leaf streak, or Sigatoka disease? Cultural practices such as improved drainage, control of weeds, removal of diseased suckers, and adopting correct spacing is recommended. Foliar spray of Mangala COC, which is copper oxychloride, at the rate of 3 grams per liter of water, or thiophenate methyl 1 grams per liter of water is recommended. Spray of trophy or agraman, which is carbendazim and mancozeb, at the rate of 2 grams per liter should be done. Apply Bordeaux mixture 1% and Yali, which is diethane M45, 0.25% alternatively at 15 days interval is also recommended. Alternation of fungicides prevents fungicidal resistance. Alternatively, spray propiconazole at the rate of 1 milliliter per liter along with petroleum-based mineral oil at the rate of 10 milliliter per liter or chlorothalonil at the rate of 1.5 grams per liter or tebuconazole at the rate of 0.5 milliliter per liter or azoxystrobin at the rate of 0.4 milliliter per liter. Use of a sticker is also recommended. The third most important disease is anthracnose. Anthracnose is also known as Gliosporium musei. The disease attacks bananas plants in all stages of growth. This disease also attacks the flowers, skin, and distal ends of the banana heads. The symptoms appear in large brown patches covered with crimson growth of the fungus. The diseased fruits turn black and the fruit is also shriveled. As we can see in the images, anthracnose causes the bananas to have dark brown patches even when they're immature. The fruits turn black and they shrivel, and the whole bunches also become black. How to control anthracnose? Spray of chlorothalonil 0.2% and prophy or Mangala agraman, which is carbendazim 12% and mancozeb 63% at the rate of 0.1% 4 times at 15 days interval is recommended. Minimizing bruising, proper sanitation of handling, and prompt cooling at 14 degrees Celsius are also essential in minimizing the disease in cold storage. The fourth important disease is cigar end tip rot. As we can see in the images, the cigar end tip rot is in two phases. One is verticillium theobromae, and the other one is conidia of verticillium theobromae. Cigar end tip rot, which is also known as verticillium theobromae, Trachyphera fructigena, and Gliosporium musarum. The symptoms of cigar end tip rot are a black necrosis spread from the preanth in the tip of the immature fingers. The rotten portion of the banana finger dries up and tends to adhere to fruits. It is similar to the ash of the cigar. As we can see in the images, the tip of the banana has rotted and gives a similar appearance as the ash of a cigar. The control measures of cigar end tip rot are removal of pistil and perianth by hand 8 to 10 days after bunch formation and spraying the bunch with Yali, which is diethane M45 at 0.1%, or Trophy or Mangala agraman, which is a solution of carbendazim and mancozeb at the rate of 0.1%, controls the disease effectively. Minimizing bruising, prompt cooling at 14 degrees Celsius, proper sanitation of handling facilities reduces the incidence in the cold storage as well. The fifth important disease is bacterial wilt or MoCo disease. Bacterial wilt or MoCo disease, the causal organism is Pseudomonas solanacearum. The young plants are affected severely. In the initial stages, the bacterial wilt is characterized by the yellowish discoloration of the inner leaf's lamina close to petioli. The leaf collapses near the junction of the lamina with the petioli. Within a week, most of the leaves exhibit wilting symptoms. The presence of yellow fingers in an otherwise green stem often indicates the presence of MoCo disease. The most characteristic symptom appear on the young suckers that have been cut once and begin regrowth. These are blackened and stunted. The tender leaves from the suckers turn yellow and necrotic. We can see the images We can see wilting of older leaves, leaves of suckers turning pale yellowish green, uneven ripening of the bunches, and we can also see discoloration of the vascular tissues. We can also see images which show the cut open bananas turning blackened and stunted. How do we control banana wilt or MoCo disease? Early detection and destruction of the suspected plants may help in preventing the spread of the disease. All the tools used for pruning and cutting should be disinfected with formaldehyde, as the insects can carry the disease, causing bacterium on the male flowers. Removal of the male flowers as soon as the last female hand emerge also helps in minimizing the spread of the disease. The next disease is banana bunchy top virus, BBTV. This disease is transmitted to the plant by aphid vector, and dwarf bananas are very susceptible to the disease. We can see the image of banana bunchy top virus on the screen. Banana bunchy top virus, the casual name is Pentalonia nigronervosa. The symptoms of banana bunchy top virus are: primary symptoms of the disease are seen when infected suckers are planted. Such infected suckers put forth narrow leaves, which are chlorotic and exhibit mosaic symptoms. The affected leaves are brittle, with their margins rolled upwards. Characteristic symptom of bunchy top virus is the presence of interrupted dark green streaks along with the secondary veins of the lamina or the midrib of the petiole. The diseased plant remains stunted and do not produce bunch of any commercial value. How do we control banana bunchy top virus? Systematic eradication of the diseased plants, suckers, and the clumps is very essential. Planting material should not be collected from the places which are affected by the disease. The aphid should be controlled to check spread of the disease by spraying Mangala Mahakil or Monocrotophos 0.05% or Paramida, which is Imidachlorophid 17.8% SL, at the rate of 1.5 to 2 milliliter per liter at 10 to 15 days into well. This process contains aphid population effectively. Plants adjacent to the healthy plants should also be sprayed. The affected plants should also be killed with kerosene or herbicides such as Clean 2,4-D or 2,4,5-T. The rhizome should be dug out, cut into small sections, and sprayed again so that no suckers can be produced which may harbor the virus. The next one is banana streak virus. It is a prominent virus exhibited by Aphis gossypi and pot virus. The virus is transmitted mostly through infected plants. Though mealybugs, which is Planococcus setrii, and more probably Saccharicoccus saccharii, are also believed to transmit it. Shoot tip culture does not eliminate it from vegetatively propagated materials. The prominent symptom exhibited by banana streak virus is yellow streaking of the leaves, which become progressively necrotic, producing a black streaked appearance in the older leaves. These symptoms can be seen on the images on the screen. We can see linear streaking and then dark streaks of on the midrib of the leaf. How do we control banana streak virus? Control strategies include use of clean planting material and quarantine, eradication of infected plant, and control of vectors are also effective in controlling the severity of the disease. The next one is banana bract mosaic virus. The symptoms of banana bat mosaic virus are, they appear as yellow-green bands or mottling over an entire area of a young leaf. The affected leaves show abnormal thickening of veins. Bunch development is also affected. We can see these symptoms on the screen. We can see mosaic streak on the bracts, and we can see the reddish streaks on the pseudostem. How do we control banana bat mosaic virus? Removal and destruction of affected plants along with rhizome. Growing cucurbits in and around banana fields should also be avoided. The next disease is mosaic virus. Mosaic virus results from cucumber mosaic virus. It converts into Aphis gossypii and vice versa. The symptoms of mosaic virus are, mosaic plants are easily recognized by their dwarf growth and mottled distorted leaves. The earliest symptoms appear on young leaves as light green or yellowish streaks and bands giving a mottled appearance. The aphid vector Aphis gossypii transmits the disease. We can see the symptoms on the screen. We can see the bunching of leaves and rotting of the heart leaf. How do we control mosaic virus? The plantation should be kept free from weeds. Suckers from infected clumps should not be used for planting. Weeds in the nearby areas should also be removed as the virus survives in them during off-season. Use of suitable insecticides to reduce the spread of the disease is also suggested. This concludes our module on pests and diseases of the banana plantation. Thank you.